I don't know when I'm working and whatnot. Don't know what game I'll fancy streaming at the time. Depends on the Xbox One selection. Ideally, obviously, I'd like to keep it as Watch Dogs, because that's going to be the to-do game anyway that I'll be playing once, well, fully committed to, so to speak, once this has been completed. So ideally, I'd like to carry on streaming that until it's completed, or until it gets up to the collectible stages. And then after that, well, the next game on the Xbox One to-do list was going to be Assassin's Creed 4. Black Flag. That'll be a new experience as well, not started that at all. I've got that on 360 as well, actually. We'll see. if the money to be made off it was right, you know what I mean. But yeah, man, I'd love to. It ain't nothing to me to sit here gaming all day. You know what I mean. I do it enough as it is when the opportunity arises. I mean, I used to game all day, every day, all the time, anyway, before kids came along. Well, outside of work, obviously. So, yeah, I love it, gaming. You know, you get people who are like, ooh, I've had a day off and I'm bored, and all that kind of shit. Nah, not the case for me, I don't get bored. There's always something I can be working on at 360. And even if, you know, I'm having a break from 360 and, you know, doing something else, there's always news to be typing or, you know, something like that. Blog to write, videos to maybe put together. Shit like that. But yeah, no, I'd love to. I think it might be hard work if I was, like, you know, obviously popular enough to do so, stream full time. Because obviously I do check out the you know, I've rarely watched streams. Because, like, if there's time to be watching a stream, there's time to be streaming myself or playing games myself, you know what I mean? So I don't ever really watch other streams, but on the odd occasion I do. There's one guy I watch, Squirrel, and he's like full-time streamer. I've like never less than like 1,000 viewers watching him at a time. I always wonder how the hell did he keep up with the chat, the speed of the chat, man. It's crazy. I mean, I know there's options to, I think, like, put it on slow mode and that, but then even if you put it on slow mode, you're still going to be behind with what people are actually saying right now. You know what I mean? But, I mean, I guess, you know, you wouldn't actually, no, you know, no disrespect to the viewers, you wouldn't need to respond to everything. It's not like people feel disrespected, they're going to understand, and obviously if you're that popular anyway, to have 1,000 odd viewers watching you, you must be doing something right to begin with. But then people have all that shit set up where people can, like, well, either pay or have some kind of option to make a you know, a special message come across the screen and all that kind of shit. Obviously, the guy stops to read that out, and then it comes up, pops up when people have subscribed to the channel and all that shit. Yeah, I could stream easy, man. I mean, I wouldn't, you know, there's not much. That's it, man. Gamers don't get bored. Especially now, man, because, like, I just don't take the time I have, my gaming time, for granted. I never did, but obviously I don't get as much time as I used to. Still do quite well, considering I've got two kids and another aunt, where times might change, though, when the third one comes along. But, you know, I never take time for granted. But anyway, like I'm saying, you know, even if I did eventually become popular with streaming and that, there's nothing much I'd change from what I do now. I wouldn't be, you know, I'm not an energetic, loud kind of guy. You know what I mean? Because you watch somebody who just, like, fucking off the reds when they're streaming, man. You just think, nah, fuck all that. I won't go down that road, just for the sake of viewers. Keep it real. Keep it me. Obviously, I wouldn't mind being able to get, like, a nice, pretty layout on the actual stream itself, but I guess it's not the most important thing, really. What's important is, like, whatever you're streaming and who's viewing really, who's watching. But
oh, you're shitting me.
Nah, they're all doing sick. Oh, come on, man, don't hold me up, man. Yeah, definitely, definitely. It's obviously it's all about building the fan base, and it, but like you said, it is the exposure, and it's whatever situation you can get in to get that exposure. It's like my YouTube in a way, you know. I wouldn't say it blew up when I got popular with it. I was doing the same thing I'd done on my YouTube from start to finish, which was like playing games I enjoyed, making montages of games I enjoyed, and making guides and whatnot of games I enjoyed. The only difference that made my YouTube popular was, and you know, it effectively blew up to the views I was getting at first, was the fact that I was the first, one of the first, to get my hands on Ghost Recon. So naturally people's search for guides and mine would have been coming up first. You know, had I not got the game as early as I did and still made the same fantastic quality videos, the story would have been different because someone else would have beat me to it. And I guess in a way it could be the same with Twitch. I might get lucky and, you know, be accidentally given a game ahead of its release. You know what I mean? And then because I'm first one to be streaming it, people who are searching for that specific game will come across my channel, and then that'll be the opportunity to build the fan base. But then obviously at the same time, it's keeping them as well. But that's what I mean after, yeah man, them Ghost Recon videos are big. But yeah, in terms of like YouTube, some of my other videos did well as well. I've you know, my other guide videos are not exactly as big as the Ghost Recon ones, but yeah, all my guys' videos tend to do a lot better than any other type of videos I made. But it's a time though as well, because obviously working, I've always worked pretty much full time. I just don't have time for it. I found myself spending way more time recording, editing, rendering, uploading, editing videos and all that kind of shit than I actually was playing games. I just didn't have time for it. You know what I mean? It's a guy. If you can afford to spend the time doing what you need to do on YouTube, then obviously you stand a lot more of a chance. You can't be like me and be part time with it and not do it when you're not feeling it. Because I only do YouTube and Twitch related stuff for games I enjoy or games I happen to be playing. I wouldn't go outside of my comfort zone just for the sake of the views. But yeah, man, nah, them Ghost Recon videos were big. So proud of them. I'm proud of all my videos, man. I love all my videos. Just a shame some of them. I feel like a lot of them didn't get the views they deserved, but it is what it is. It's one of them. It's like you can tell that with some people, once they've obviously done something right along the way to get the amount of fans that they've got, and then they've got to that stage where, like, they could just upload anything. It could be, wow.
That's it? That's a lot of you? Fucking pathetic.
It could be, yeah, they could upload, like, what's shooting me there? They could upload anything, and just because the fan base is that strong and it'd have so many people that just come check it out. The set for life. You do get some popular YouTubers who just upload shite and they get millions of views off it for no reason. Well, not for no reason, but you know what I mean. Because the fan base is that strong. They're just gonna the views will just pretty much automatically rake it right in. But then at the same time, you know, it's obviously putting the effort in to get yourself out there, get hooked up with the right people, ask for help off the right people, you know, try and get partnered with the right guys, you know what I mean, who can help you with the exposure as well.
Just need a name, please.
I apologize in advance for any scandal.
Depends, man. Depends.
I've been training, you know, ignoring my kids.
I definitely, I don't know, because it's like I was saying before. You know, I with the Xbox being set up downstairs, I mean, you know, I could go as far as moving Xbox upstairs and bring it 360 downstairs, but that's not how I want it. Kids will be, you know, pissing around, and you know, being in the living room, obviously the natural things that go on in a busy house are going to be going on. It's going to be hard to focus, so I don't think it's not going to make for ideal streams. I'll still try anyway. But then in terms of recording actual content, you know, possibly making guides and whatnot, I don't know. Depends really on how well I can use the record that feature. Because I've not exactly got a cap card. I mean, I guess obviously if I just naturally stream everything, anything I do happen to capture that could be made into you know, guide material I could clip from the Twitch video. But yeah, no, I definitely like to get some videos up. But again, it, you know, streaming it alone would hopefully bring some viewers in. But depends when I get it. I mean, you know, obviously I'm intending to get it on day one, because one thing is, like, you know, I have obviously played a lot of decent games that I would have loved to make videos and guides for, but sometimes there's no point. If the game's been hammered that much on YouTube and people have got like 100, you know, people obviously people want to make their own guides, but then a lot of the time you see loads of videos for one achievement and everyone's pretty much doing the same thing but in their own voice or whatever, you know what I mean? Everyone makes different guides, but technically they're all the same. I don't bother with all that shit. If there's good enough guides on the internet for a game, there's no point in me putting another one on top. It's only when I can offer something different in a guide, i.e. Metal Gear Solid was a good example. You know what I mean? That's when I'll go to the extent of making guides for older games. But if I get beat out on the Division stuff, not much point really. But obviously that shouldn't really happen if I can, if I'm going to get it on day one anyway. So yeah, no, definitely will try and make some content if I can for that. Perhaps for me, the only problem I have, if for me to make YouTube content from Xbox One, you know, obviously I can abuse the record that feature, upload the clips to my OneDrive, download them back from that, put them into my video editing software, away I go. But when it's trying to edit Twitch stuff is a bit more difficult, because you can archive it and export it to YouTube. But I'm not really sure how you download it back from YouTube then, or download the stream itself. Because if I'm going to make any content that I think might gain a lot of views, you've got to get it on YouTube, because that's where obviously I can monetize it and that, and make a little change off it. Twitch videos and game Xbox One game clips, you're making no money off them. You know what I mean? Granted, you know, you still get a bit of exposure, so to speak, but it's not as beneficial as YouTube. YouTube's still the source, because obviously on my YouTube channel I'm still technically partnered with Social Blade, or Maker, whoever I'm partnered with. So there's no issue for me to get my shit monetized, unless obviously it's got copyright music in it. Because when you're not partnered, well, before I was partnered, trying to get anything monetized was a right pain in the ass. But all of a sudden when you're partnered, it's a different story. It's like easy to get shit monetized, just flick of a button. You're not partnered, you gotta submit like fucking evidence that the content's yours and all that kind of bullshit. I never got anything monetized when I weren't partnered. Or maybe one video. There was a vlog. And even then some of my vlogs really wouldn't let me monetize. But yeah, anyway. definitely try and get some, definitely be some streams and hopeful clips and YouTube videos to come from The Division. But you know, if I had Xbox One upstairs, I'd be flying then. Because I could just hammer it to my heart's content if I'm sat down here trying to hammer games. It's not going to work. I mean, it could do though, depending on the release date. You know, I am pretty hyped about it, so I am going to go to the extent of, you know, possibly booking a week off, maybe even 2 weeks. No, it's going to be early in January, so probably a week. Book a week off and that, so there'll be no reason for me to get some late nights on go. But then again, baby will be born by that time, so if I'm going to be staying up late, I'm going to end up on fucking baby duty. I have to keep on taking like half hour breaks to sort child out, probably need feeding and all that kind of shit. We'll see what the future brings. Me missus, you know, I make out like I'm proper or done by when it comes to gaming time, but considering I've got two kids, I probably fit more gaming time in now on average than I did when I just only had one kid. It's like, with me missus being in the house all the time and not working.
If we're both sat here in day and that, she always lets me just pretty much do what I want
on my days off. It's like today. What have I done today? Oh no, we had a hospital appointment and that earlier, but besides that, I was upstairs most of the evening, writing news on True Achievements. So I could have been sat on Xbox all night if I wanted to, and then come downstairs about 10:30 or something, sat here playing Xbox One. You know what I mean? I had to lift a finger in terms of like sorting kids out or anything like that, so. My missus does put up with me gaming habits quite well. But it's just like, you know, when I've got three kids. I mean, I don't know, I said the same shit when my second child was going to be born, you know what I mean? That I was going to lose gaming time. So it might not be the case, really. Obviously, the first few months, newborn baby and that would be a bit tougher. But then again, at the same time, you know, it does have its ups and downs because a newborn baby pretty much eats, sleeps and shits, and mostly sleeps, so might not be that big of an issue. But then again, my middle child, she'll be crawling and trying to stand and all that by the time new baby's born, so could be a handful. We'll see what the future brings. Man, this shit's not a joke. You know what I missed out on in terms of YouTubing and Twitching, man? Was fucking streaming for 360. I could have got on that well earlier. It was only recently I figured out how to do it. A few simple instructions off one of my fellow news hounds, and like I had it set up within like a half hour or something. The only thing I was missing was a decent headset to speak through, but I could have been streaming a lot. Once I got it set up, I thought, wow, I could have been doing this a lot sooner. So in terms of like streaming some of me fucking amazing 360 completions, you know what I mean, I just smashed the two Lost Planets as well, the first two Lost Planets. Well, as in Lost Planet Extreme Conditions and the Colonies Edition, so there would have been mint streaming material. So I missed out on some really good streaming content as well. Just like me ability to stream through the 360s come at the wrong time really, when it's gonna be fizzling out.
Maybe the meth diet does work.
I have no more like really hard 360 games that
that I know I'd be able to smash with practice to stream. Well, I haven't. I've got some fucking notoriously hard arcade games to possibly attempt if I can be asked. Oh shit. That karma came and knocked me the fuck off my bike there. Was it gone? Shit, come on. I have to do all that swimming bullshit again. Fuck's, I can't believe that just happened. Stupid. What was I saying? Oh yeah, Xbox Live Arcade games. Like, well, a lot of Xbox Live Arcade games are hard anyway, but often a shit that I just never bother going back to. I think, like, hard good games. Earthworm Jim, that seems to be one that's people are struggling to complete. You think you got to complete the game without dying. Hard Corps Uprising's got some ridiculous hard achievements, but that's a banging ass game. I'd love to be able to get the full completion on that. But yeah, no, man, 360 streaming's it's relatively simple. Not as simple as obviously streaming on Xbox One. But if you, because obviously I've always had the Roxy or Game Capture anyway for recording 360 gameplay. So you use that. No, do you? Yeah, you need, no. Hold on, let me think. Yeah, you need a GameCap device anywhere to be able to get the whatever's coming up on your TV screen through to your laptop, which then goes through to another program. I use OBS, Open Broadcast Software. And then through your OBS, you just configure it to go from that to the Twitch itself. Well, you do have to tweak with a few, you know, different settings and whatnot. Know what audio settings and whatnot to adjust, and then away you go. See, that's the thing I didn't know at first, was how to turn down the actual ingate, the volume that outputs to the stream, because it used to be like absolute full whack. And I didn't know how to turn it down at all. I was messing with in-game volumes to try and turn it down and like playing the game in silence. But it turns out there was another set of settings that I hadn't looked at. I'm not doing good here. The only difference with 360 is I've not got a camera to make myself appear in the stream. Not that that's the really that important. I should have used Michael to do this. How far they are ahead now.
Blow me.
They fell off the bikes or something. Well, I'd originally looked at 360 streaming, 360 streaming ages ago. Well, around the time I started YouTubing and that, but from the stuff I looked at, it looked as if you was gonna have to pay for the software to make the stream appear to Twitch, because obviously the Roxio game capture didn't have any streaming like capabilities options with it, whereas some game captures do. So I think if you get a Roxio HD or maybe like an Elgato or something, then you can use that same software to stream, whereas with the Roxio you can't. You can use the Roxio to, you know, make the content itself come up for your laptop, but then you need a different software program to the one Roxio has to manage it all. So I'd originally looked at it, wasn't overly fussed about streaming anyway, left it at that. But then when I started streaming with True Achievements, that's when I looked into it more and realised there was a free software program to be able to do it. And obviously I wanted to mix up the streams a bit and not always have it just be an Xbox One stream. And then obviously some nights, that's why I do like, during the week, when I do like my Tuesday TA stream, I'll do it downstairs. So then she can like go to bed and that, and I'm not like causing her disruption with her sleep. And then at weekends when she can stay up later, I'll go upstairs instead and stream upstairs. And obviously, you know, 360's still banging, man. Still good games on there. I know some people who say like they wouldn't dream of going back to 360, but I'm still happy playing on both, man. Obviously, you know, yeah, Xbox One's great and it's got amazing features with it, and obviously graphically you can see the massive improvements, but you know, gameplay is where it's at really for most games. So in terms of 360 games, there's still banging ass titles out there that I've yet to play. YouTube is slacking on that shit, man. They'll find it so hard now to really dominate over Twitch. But, I mean, you know, there's potential there. Because if it's nice and straightforward and you can interlink it with your actual YouTube channel and then you can have everything under one roof, that could be really sweet. And then if you're partnered as well and you can, you know, get straight into the monetizing side of it, that would be pretty nice. I mean, I know they do... Yeah, they do like live events type thing. I've only ever actually watched one, but they're just, you know, they're not. I don't know. They don't come across as appealing as like streams do. Obviously, Twitch is the king for like streaming and stuff. But I remember watching like Hodge. I don't know if you've ever heard of Hodge Twins. Obviously, they do a lot of videos, like pretty much making the latest and greatest news funny type shit. And they did like a live kind of thing once, which was quite good. But I looked into that as well on the YouTube side of things, doing live events, and I didn't really, couldn't really grasp how to get it going. But yeah, man, like I was saying, get all that shit under one roof. Not having to flick from Twitch to YouTube and all that kind of shit, that'd be good. Just depends how they set it up, how they lay it out. Would it be easy to bring your Twitch fan base over to YouTube? I mean, I know it's not a massive thing for me. I've only got 24 followers, but, you know, for some, that'd be a big decision. I can't believe how long this triathlon is, man. I need to go to bed. Probably going to call it a night after this event. I'm going to be absolutely cabbaged in the morning. I need to be fresh. Fresh for answering them phone calls. I'm going to smash it out tomorrow and get my stats up a bit. I ain't going to get no damn bonus again. Yeah, man. Man's built up the stamina, you two are suffering now.
Son of a bitch.
And then as I said earlier, I'll be back tomorrow night on the on the 360 side of things for some Arkham Origins. Which I'm looking forward to. I really enjoyed the Batman games. Oh, and that's another one as well, actually. Batman Arkham Knight coming out for Xbox One. That could be big.
Get back here.
Get a copy of that early doors and do some streaming stuff on that. That'd be brilliant.
Let's go.
My job. It's alright, man. You know, first and foremost, I'm grateful to have a job. I'd never been down that road of, being unemployed before.
Have fun!
Even though it was only short-lived, it was only like a couple of weeks or something, but still. I don't know, I didn't really feel the effect of it, to be honest, because I got a pretty healthy payday from my previous job at the time. So I knew I had a few months to get sorted out, but obviously I just got it sorted out ASAP, so I didn't get to that stage of having no cash and no job.
Come on, team.
No, it's not bad. You've got to be... you're not necessarily going to have the stomach for it, but you've got to be prepared to deal with not very happy customers. As we are the retention team, as they call it, the loyalty team. So 90% of the phone calls are never really that pleasant, unless you do get the few customers who come through to your department when they shouldn't have really, but obviously you're going to take happy and just general inquiring customers over the outright pissed off ones. But no, it's not been bad. Hours have been decent. I don't start any earlier than 8 o'clock in the morning. I don't finish any later than 8 o'clock at night. Well, I'm not supposed to finish any later than 8 o'clock at night, but if you get stuck on phone, that's a different story. But the job itself is okay. The only thing that it's early days so far, so I don't want to be too judgmental about it, but basically to get bonus. Obviously there's targets to hit and whatnot. Why's my stream gone off? Bear with me, unless the stream is still alive, but it doesn't look like it is from my end. Oh, and here comes the change request. I knew it, man. Is the stream still alive for anyone, if you can still hear me? I knew that. Got worried then, man. I got scared. Forgot what I was saying now, man. And then I got a message on through achievements as well. Put me off. Hey, story's been published. Oh yeah, job. Yeah, so basically I'm in the loyalty department and you know, the main thing of the job is to obviously, we get the calls where people have expressed that they want to cancel. Unless, obviously, if they're speaking to another department and they express that they want to cancel the services, then they get transferred through to us, and obviously it's our job to try and save that customer, unless they ring up and get directly through to the department. But then, you know, you get bonuses for percentage of customers you save, and yeah, then there's another part of the bonus with how much cash you spend per save, and you know, all that kind of jazz. If you upsold this and added value and blah blah blah. But then there's gateways to the bonus, in which if you fail any of the... How many gateways would there be? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's about 5 gateways you have to get through. If you fail one of those gateways, it doesn't matter. Wow, what's he doing? Oh, I'm pressing the wrong button. If you fail any one of those gateways, you don't get any bonus at all, so it doesn't matter how brilliant you might have done with the rest of your bonus deck. You wouldn't get any. But the gateways focus more on actually selling than actually retaining the customer. So for example, you know, you need to have sold a certain percentage of fibre and mobile and TV to the customers you've spoke to. Which obviously, you know, I can understand and I can appreciate why they do that, but it just makes more sense to me personally. Why don't you make the gateways about what the job's actually about to begin with? Because customers coming through pissed off about something, you want to fix the problem first. Then you want to say, okay, right, let's see what else we can offer you type thing, you know what I mean? The problem and solving the problem comes first. So in terms of how the bonus is structured, then why not make it, okay, first things first, fix the problem, let's make the gateways about that. You know what I mean? You're going to fix the problem, then a bonus on top of that is you're selling something to the customer. You know what I mean? So make the extra bonus about the selling. It's like the bonus is the opposite way around to what your actual job's about, which kind of pisses me off. And it's not that easy to sell to everyone, because some people, they're pissed off and are absolutely adamant that they're cancelling the services. How the fuck are you supposed to sell them anything? Or people coming through because they want to reduce the cost of the bills. How the fuck are you supposed to sell them anything? You know what I mean? They want to go on the lowest package. But then that's what another... Actually, that's another one of your gateways. There's only a certain percentage of customers you can downgrade. I think it's less than 4% that you've got it that you can downgrade. Otherwise, you fail that gateway. So I am very sceptical about how the bonus works. I mean, the basic rate itself before bonus isn't too bad, to be honest with you. So that's good. And you know, I've only been there for about 7 weeks now, but the first 3 weeks were training. So we worked on the forms from the middle of April. So we only had that half of the month to try and get the bonus, which was like Mission Impossible. So this is the first month where we've had a full month to try and obtain the bonus. So
I got this.
It's gonna show us whether the bonuses are really achievable or not. But at the same time, again, like I say, you know, I'm trying not to be too judgmental. It is, even though, yeah, fair enough, it is our first full month to try and hit the bonus, we are still, you know, fairly new to the job. So go on. Why did he swerve like that? So you can't, you know, I can't expect to be hitting top line straight away. It's going to take, obviously, experience to do so, but sooner I can start getting top line bonus, the better. Because, you know, I could certainly use the cash. Or I could, you know, I wouldn't mind being able to stash the cash, get it built up. Because I'm not one of these guys who feels it, you know what I mean, has cash in the bank and needs to spend it. I mean, I'm always trying to save everything that I can for when I do need to spend it. But exactly. All depends on the customer at the same time. That's what I mean. That's what makes it so hard. We're not, you know, people are ringing up because they got problems or they want to leave. There's something negative about the reason why they've been needed to, have been put through to us to begin with. So, you know what I mean. If you can't solve the problem, you ain't selling them shit. And on top of that, you know, we don't. Our department doesn't handle new sales, first-time customers, or anything like that. So there's never those opportunities. And then if you speak to customers and you might offer them a great deal, they could go, "Oh, well, you know, I'll go away and think about it," type thing. And they could ring back and just go through to the actual proper sales team, and that ain't gonna benefit you in any way. So, you know, there's a few pros and cons to it so far, but early days. I certainly can't grumble about the hours. I think last weekend was the first like weekend I'd worked in about 4 months or something. Obviously, back in my retail days, weekends were relentless. And then I'm working tomorrow, 8 till 4. And then I'm off Sunday, back in all week, off the next weekend, and then off for the Monday and Tuesday as well. So I've got 4 days off on trot. And then I don't know what my hours are. I think I'm off that the Sunday after that as well. So the hours are definitely more sensible, which is nice.
Come on, Trevor.
I've no stamina. I need to step it up. Fuck it. Let's kill ourselves. That guy at front, man. What's he called again? Usain fucking Bolt.
Piece of shit.
I thought I'd only been like 10 minutes doing this. I forgot how long this one was. Come on. Exactly, man. Exactly.
No, you're shitting me.
But even then, one at targets is you're targeted on how much you spend per customer as well. And some of them, you've really got to throw everything at them just to get the sale out of them. Some of the money I've spent on customers has been unreal. I mean, it's not that bad in a way. I think the top line target is something like about £12 for customer. So if you get a customer through and you save that customer and you didn't spend anything on them, then obviously your average will kind of lower by a lot. You know what I mean? Effectively, you've not spent anything on that customer, so now you've got more cash to spend on the next customer.
I think the top line target average is about £12. Bottom line, about £18, something like that. No, I don't know. I can't remember what it is, but I think I'm twice over the average. I think I'm about £34 per customer at a minute, so I really need to get it down.
Oh, shit! Oh no.
Oh, come on.
I can't fucking believe it. How long did I spend doing that as well? 30 minutes to come forth. I'm going to have to do all that again at another point. Yeah, that one's terrible. I knew it was a long one, I forgot how long it was, I didn't think it was that long, but fuck's sake. Depends actually, because no medal popped up, unless it's because I was fourth, and I didn't get awarded a medal anywhere. See what the guide says, see if it needed to actually be done. Story missions, hobbies and pastimes. So it's not part of the hobbies and pastimes. Strangers and Freaks. It's not in that. Random events, blah blah blah. Spaceship parts, lot of scraps under the bridge, knife flight, stunt jumps. Purchase a vehicle via the web. Oh, so according to a guide, I didn't even actually need to do triathlons anywhere. Whatever. That just had me achievement app brought on screen, but you can't see it. Can't see it when I pull it up in the stream. So when I come back to GTA, I shall be doing... Oh, it's not even ticked. I'll save that for another time and see if I do, if that actually does count towards 100%. There's another boat race to do. I'll let Michael do that. Boat race. I need to do this. Arms trafficking. I think I've got to do 5 of each. 5 ground, 5 air. And then, I'll have to do some hunting. We'll do boat race. Get that Kiflam shit out of the way while I'm using Michael as well.
Hey, baby, you looking for a date?
Nope, just window shopping. Happily married now.
Come back when you change your mind, hun.
I was going to have a blast at the boat race now, but it's getting a bit late.
Hey, I'll take a rain check. This car ain't big enough.
New banging the prostitutes. Quickly do this one and then call it a night. Then I'll continue with the boat race next time. Probably tomorrow. Oh no, it ain't gonna be tomorrow. I'm streaming tomorrow. Oh no, Batman tomorrow, Batman. Saying that, I might get a few streams going on this channel this week anyway. I'm on late shifts all week, so about time to get home and chill out and that and whatnot. She'll be going to bed and I'll probably sit down here and smash this. I just picked it up. Oh, sick, right outside my house as well.
I'm still alive, in case you're wondering.
TSEV tomorrow. Oh, look at the family. Yeah.
What have you been up to?
Jimmy's trying and failing to get fit.
Yeah? And I should only be really protein loading right now, but this is an exception.
At 5 o'clock in the morning, everyone would be up, chilling in the kitchen. Yeah, True Achievements TV tomorrow. 360 man. True Achievements TV on Tuesday for Watch Dogs, and then any time outside that, I'll just jump on my own channel. What's going on Sunday? Sunday I might be going to her mum's for Sunday dinner, but I might Sunday. So Sunday night, I don't know, because then I have to bath kids and all that. Don't know. I'm trying to think. We'll see. We'll see. Definitely tomorrow for True Achievements TV. And if I do get a chance between tomorrow and Tuesday, I'll just jump on my own channel. Whether or not that'll be 360 or Xbox One will be TBA. So yeah, that is me. I am out of here. Yeah, so tomorrow night, tune in. Batman Arkham Origins Cold Heart DLC on the 360 should be fun. First time trying out the DLC. Paid full goddamn price for it, so it best I'd be good, but I think it'll be good. So yeah, stay tuned for that tomorrow night. It's going to be, what time? 8 o'clock, I think. 8 o'clock UK time. I'll just check, actually. I'm not sure, really, to be honest, Ezra. I mean, the potential is the easy, you know what I mean? Because it's as you probably know, it's a successful website, still growing. But obviously the Twitch side of things is still, well, it's, you know, I can't really say it's early days anymore. 8 PM tomorrow, Batman is, GMT Zero. I just don't think we've got as many things in place as we'd like to have for the Twitch side of the website. Because we've not even really promoted it on the site as much as we could yet. I mean, I know TA himself is a busy man, so when he gets a chance, I think he's going to experiment with a few things, and then once we're comfy and set in our ways, get the site promoted properly on you know, through the site itself, and go from there. But yeah, I don't see why they won't be able to get partnered with Twitch eventually. Plus, obviously, it'd be beneficial for the site as well. You know, more that little bit of money coming in means more things for the site, doesn't it? Really, possible payday for the streamers as well. Hey, but anyway, cheers for tuning in, Desraw. Pleasure as always, and whoever else may have been watching, I can see I've had a steady 2 viewers, so that's cool. So yeah, nice one guys, see you tomorrow night if you're available, 8 PM sharp for some Batman Arkham Origins action. So until then, take care of yourselves and enjoy the weekend.